Good morning, students. In the last class, we have discussed about the particular integrals when f of x is equal to e power ax with the inverse operator 1 by f of d is operating on some function x. That function we are considered e power ax. And we know that the inverse operator 1 by d is nothing but integral of that function. 1 by d of x is equal to y. Derivative and inverse operator both are inverse operators. And this is the formula number C is very important when the function is either secant ax or cosecant ax or cot ax. When the particular integral is not in the standard form, we have to apply this formula, this highlighted formula. We have to apply this formula. 1 by d minus a of some function e power ax e power minus ax into x. Whenever x is either secant ax or cosecant ax, cot ax, secant ax, we have to apply this formula, this integral formula. You know how to do the integration. Some real part and imaginary part will come, that I will show in the next slide. This is the general method and explaining. Some shortcut methods are also there. Now, this is an important problem. The examination point of view, solve the differential equation d square y by dx square is equal plus a square y is equal secant ax. Write the complementary function roots r plus r minus ai. Now, whenever secant ax is there, there is no shortcut method. Apply the general formula. Take the partial fractions d plus ai, d minus ai, with the help of the partial fractions, get the integral. I am showing the first integral, 1 by d minus alpha, alpha is equal ai. Apply the formula e power iax integral secant ax e power minus iax. You know, from Euler's theorem, e power minus iax is equal to cos ax minus sin ax. E power I theta is equal to cos theta minus I sin theta. Write that value and simplify the integral. Get the integral value. Integration of tan logarithm of secant ax by a due to this minus, it will becomes plus. Now, no need to compute the second integral again, because we are calculated 1 by d minus alpha. Here alpha is equal to how much? Minus ia. Means wherever in the above integral I is there, just replace minus I. E power minus iax, e power minus iax into x minus I logarithm of cos ax by a. If you complete the calculation for 1 by d minus ia, the calculation of 1 by d plus ia is very simple. Wherever I is there, replace minus I, the obtained result. Now, what is the final result we are expecting? The final result we are expecting is this value. Substitute these values in equation number 4. Get the particular integral. This is a general method. Whenever secant, the right hand side part is secant ax, cosecant ax, cot ax, tan ax, or some logarithmic function, any function is there. That way we have to do it. One more example I am showing. The same process, the function is changed only. See, in example number 6, the function is, the right hand side non-zero part is cosecant ax. There is no shortcut methods are there. So, we have to use the partial fractions method. In the partial fractions method, same formula, 1 by d minus ia cosecant ax e power alpha x, this is the formula, 1 by d minus a, the inverse operator, is operating on x. E power ax integration of e power minus ax into x. Capital X is equal to how much here? Cosecant ax. Apply the Euler's formula, simplify the integral, get the result. Similarly, for the second result, replace I with minus I as we have discussed earlier. And you know that what is sin ax? E power iax minus e power minus iax by 2i. Very important formula. cos ax is equal e power iax plus e power minus iax by 2. It is not hyperbolic, it is trigonometric functions. Hyperbolic means what? Sin hx is equal e power x minus e power minus x by 2. Only x variable. Whenever trigonometric functions are there, imaginary part will come, I will come. That will be noted. That I am highlighting here like this. These are the formulas are important. Now, there are some shortcut methods are also there. This is the general method. The general method, whenever shortcut methods are not possible, we can solve the particular integral by using the formula 1 by d minus alpha into f of x. Exponential function, case 1 we have discussed in the previous class. Right? Let me go to the next case when in the example cos hyperbolic is there. What is cos hyperbolic? E power x plus e power minus x by 2. Instead of x, how much is there? 2x minus 1. Separate them. 1 by d is acting like a linear operator. Apply the exponential principle rule. Get the value. Case 2. Now, this is very, very important case 2. When f of x is equal sin ax plus b or cos ax plus b, then the particular integral is obtained by 1 by f of d is operating on either sin ax plus b or cos ax plus b, or sin ax, b is absent, it is sin ax or cos ax. The working rule is replace d square with minus a square provided f of minus a square is not equals to 0. Replace d square with minus a square. If d square terms are not there, generate the d square terms by multiplying with the rationalization factor. Suppose the value becomes 0, 1 by f of d square of sin ax plus b is an important formula. 4a should be noted, students. 1 by f of d square, if that value, when you replace d square with minus a square, the denominator becomes 0, then there is a formula is there. What is that formula? 1 by f of d square of sin ax plus b is equal minus x by 2a cos ax plus b. That I will show. That's a slide. That is a case of failure. If it is not equals to 0, is okay. If it is equals to 0, 1 by f of d square of sin ax or sin ax plus b is equal minus x by 2a into cos of ax plus b. Take pen and paper, write that formula. Minus x by 2a cos ax plus b. Whenever sin is there, a minus sign will come. Whenever cos is there, the case of failure, it is x by 2a cos of ax plus b. If that formula is available, I will show here. Now, the working rule here for cos function, you can write the complementary function. The roots are 1 by 2 comma minus 1. C1 e power 4x plus C2 e power minus x. C1 e power half x plus C2 e power minus x. Now I am talking about the particular integral. What is the working rule? Wherever d square is there for a cos function or sine function, replace d square with only d square with is d square with minus a square. How much a? A is equal to 2. A is equal to 2 minus 4 plus d minus 1. So only r powers of d degree will be left out. If any d cube terms are there, can be written as d square into d. Like that. Now, d minus 9, we must generate the d square terms. So, multiply with the rationalization factor d plus 9 and divide with d plus 9. So, here two operators are presented. One is inverse operator, one is differential operator. First, finish the inverse operator. D square is equal to minus a square, minus 4. Then, apply the differential operator. What is d? Derivative. Derivative of cos 2x minus 2 sin 2x, 9 cos 2x. Like that. Get the particular integral. What is the working rule? Whenever d terms are presented, generate d square terms by multiplying with the rationalization factor. One more example. Directly it is a case of failure. How come? D square plus 4 into sin 2x. D square is equal to, if I substitute minus a square, minus 4 plus 4. Minus 4 plus 4 becomes 0. Whenever it is 0, the formula is minus x by 2a cos ax. Minus x by 2a cos ax. formula minus x by 2a cos ax, like that, case of value directly. For sin, a minus sign will come. The same formula for cos plus x by 2a sin ax. Is that clear? Now, move to the next function, right hand side, x power m. What is x power m? A algebraic polynomial, where m is a positive integer. Here we have to apply the binomial principle. These formulas students must remember. These four formulas must remember. 1 minus d whole power minus 1 is equal to 1 plus d square plus like so on. 1 plus d upon minus 1 alternating signs. 1 minus d power minus 2, 1 plus 2d plus 3d square, etc. Now here, this example number 12, solve d cube y by dx cube minus d square y by dx square minus 6dy by dx is equal to 1 plus x square. I am explaining only the particular integral when x cube term is there or x square, algebraic function is there. Right? Take out the least degree term common in the differential operator or try to take the partial fractions. What are the partial fractions? D into d plus 2 into d minus 3 are the factors. Get the partial fraction. That is the easiest way. Then apply on the function or take out the least degree term. 1 will come because in the formula 1 is everywhere, 1 is there. I want 1. That way I have to take the least degree term common and expand this denominator 1 plus d square d by 6 minus d square by 6 in the binomial form. And remember that x degree is 2. In this expansion, only consider d square terms, up to the terms d square. It is equal to the degree of x. I'm writing the expanded form. 1 minus d by 6 minus d square by 6. In this a minus b whole square, the first term only required. Second term d power 4 will come. Fourth derivative of x square becomes 0. I am talking about x square only. 1 is what? 1 is a exponential function. E power 0 x we can write. Right. That way you can do it, or it is x power 0 also we can consider. No problem. I am explaining once again. 1 separately written as e power 0 x. Exponential principle you can apply. Or if you consider this is a polynomial, you apply this principle. Consider up to d square terms, which is equal to the highest degree of x, x square. So, you know, what is the derivative of this function? 2x. Second derivative of this function, 2. Like that. Simplified, get the result. In example number 13 also, x square term is there. So, our aim is to take the d square term. So, finally, 1 by d will be left out. What is 1 by d? In the above example, 1 by d is nothing but integral. After getting the result, you integrate this one. X square integration is x cube by 3, x square by 6, 25 by 18 into x, like that. Or I already suggested partial fractions are also simple way. How partial fractions? 1 by d, 1 by d minus 3, 1 by d plus 2. A by d is b by d minus 3, c by d plus 2. Separately operate, linear operator is operating on whenever the function is addition or subtraction, the linear operator can be applicable. Individually, plus signs, minus sign can be separated. That is the linear operator property. Here also, the same treatment. Take out the lowest degree term common. So, that 16. Again, 16, if I take common, 1 is required. This one term is required. So, that binomial theorem is applicable. What is the highest degree of x? 2. Consider the terms up to d square. 1 plus some phi of d. 1 minus d. If I take plus d square, what happens? D power 4 will come. That I don't want. That we don't want. Because there is a formula. Students should be noted. D power n of x power n is equal to n factorial. Nth derivative of x power n is n factorial. So that it will becomes very easy. So that say consider terms up to second degree. That is equal to the polynomial degree. Whenever d square is there, finally after getting the simplification, d square means what? 2 times you have to integrate this function. X square is x cube by 3 plus 1 by d square can be written 1 by d into 1 by d. 1 time first integrate it. Afterwards again 1 by d you operate. Get the result. Then y general solution is equal to y complementary function plus y particular integral. Now move to case 4. When your right hand side is a product with the exponential function. A product with the exponential function. The working rule is take out e power ax outside, take out e power ax outside of the inverse operator, replace d with d plus a. This inverse operator is applicable only on v of x. E power ax is acting like a constant. What we have done? Take out e power ax outside and simultaneously replace d with d plus a. This is the working rule. Just to remember. Now the current counter example is e power x is multiplied with cos x. E power x is multiplied with cos x, write the complementary function. I am talking about the particular integral. So e power x, how much a? E power x, a is equal to 1. Take out e power x outside of the inverse operator and replace d with d plus a. D with d plus a. Okay. Then this inverse operator is operating on only on the cos x. What is the working rule for expanded? Cos ax replace d square with minus a square. D power 4 can be written as d square whole square. D cube can be written as d into d square. And d square, there is a working rule. D term only will be alone. What is the d term? 4d minus 4d, luckily here cancelled. If only 1 by d is there, integrated. Wherever d square is there, replace a square. A is equal to how much? 1. A is equal to 1. D square is equal minus a square. Whenever 1 by d term is alone only, what is 1 by d of some function? Integration of that function, my dear friends. And the another example is, this is a typical problem, e power x, general formula we have to apply. After writing the complementary function, and e power x into e power x. E power e power x, d square plus 3d plus 2, that formula we have to apply. Comparable with e power ax into v of x. Not like that. This is the here you have to apply the general formula. What is the general formula? E power alpha x into, take out the partial fractions, as we have discussed general formula for secant ax, the other is written wrong. E power x is there. It is not of the type e power ax into v of x. Take the partial fractions, a by d plus 1, b by d plus 2, then apply this formula individually, 1 by d minus alpha of x, e power minus alpha x into capital X. What is capital X? E power x. Take e power x is equal to t, get the integral, get the integral, very easy. Alternatively, here he is showing the alternative method. This is simple method, that is taking the partial fractions and applying the general formula, e power alpha x into alpha is equal to minus 1. Here alpha is equal to minus 2. Alpha is equal to minus 1. Alpha is equal to minus 2 is an important problem. And students, whenever sin square x, cos square x terms are there, sin square x, cos square term, terms are there, linearize it while calculating the, here exponential function is there, take exponential shift outside, replace d with d plus 2. Same treatment, x square is there, consider the terms up to d square. Okay? But here in the second integral, I am talking about the second integral, sin square x is there. What is sin square x? 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Suppose cos square x sometimes will come in the examination. 1 plus cos 2x by 2. Then operate the linear operator separately, individually, 1 by 2d e power 0x. E power 0x is what? Yeah, 1, integration of 1 is x. Either way, you will get x only. Here cos working rule we have to apply. D square with minus a square. D cube is there, d into d square. 3d plus 8 will come. Rationalization factor, 3d minus 8. Multiply and divide it. First finish the inverse operator. Then operate the differential operator. And when the case 5, when x is equal to x into v, students take a pen and paper, x into v, the formula will be x minus f dash d by f of d into v by f of d. This way also you can do it. This is another formula. The simple way is x minus f dash d by f of d, x is separate, x minus f dash d by f of d, it is possible, I will write here, x minus f dash d by f of d into v by f of d. X minus f dash d by f of d into v by f of d. That way you can apply. X sin x is there. So this is the formula from the above formula also you can do it. 1 by d square plus 4. Or simple formula is what? X minus f dash d. F dash d means what? D square plus 4 derivative 2d. 2d by d square plus 4 bracket into sin x by d square plus 4. This way we can do it. The particular integral is. And here three functions are in product. It's a very important problem. A 10 marks problem. It's a very important problem. Three functions are in product. What is the working rule first? Take out e power x outside and replace d with d plus 1. So x sin x will be there. That x sin x is first to operate. Take out x outside sin x. Derivative of this function operating on sin x. So what the sin rule? D with d square with minus a square. Generate the d square term. Here also generate the d square term. X outside 1 by f of d of sin x, derivative of 1 by f of d into the function sin x. Right, the three functions are in product. This formula we have applied, the above formula. That is the formula x into v by f of d minus f of d by f of d whole square of xv. 1 by f of d xv, x you can take outside. Right. So xv, only this formula is required. This formula. X into v by f of d minus f dash d by f of d into v by f of d. One more time I am showing. Exponential function we are taking outside. X into sin x. X into sin x. And the derivative of this term. 1 by d square plus 2d plus 6. This way we can do it. And this is example number 19 is very, very important. It is this model is not there. Generally, the JNTO people will ask sin square x, imaginary part we can write. Imaginary part. But here, when I take e power 2x outside, d plus d with d plus 2, 1 by d square will come. 1 by d square means what? Integrate twice this function. Integrate twice this function. You know, integration. Right. While doing the integration, bypass formula we have to apply. Bypass formula we have to apply. Right. Another formula, same alternatively, sin 2x can be written as what? Imaginary part of e power 2ix. Already, two exponential functions are there. If bases are equal, we can add the powers. So, replace d with d plus 2i, working rule. Already we have taken e power 2x outside. Now one more exponential function d with d plus 2i. Take the binomial expansion because x square algebraic function is there. Consider the terms up to d square. And final answer, consider only the imaginary part. There are two parts are there, real part as well as imaginary part. We can consider only the imaginary part. If the same problem is given for cos 2x, the same problem is given cos 2x, here sin 2x plus cos 2x is given, then sin cos 2x can be written as what? Real part of e power I 2x. That way we can do it. Real part. And afterwards, what is the final conclusion? Y general solution is equal to y complementary function plus y particular integral. And the simplification point of view, binomial expansion, consider the terms up to d square terms. D square terms. And d square of x square is 2 factorial. Second derivative of x square is constant. First derivative of x is constant. So here x square term is there. Consider the terms up to d square. Consider the terms up to d square students. You know that e power ix is equal cos x plus I sin x. Take pen and paper. E power ix is equal cos x plus I sin x. Cos x is called the real part of e power ix. Sin x is called the imaginary part of e power ix. This point you have to remember while calculating the particular integral. When three functions are in product, no problem. Take out e power ix outside. Replace d with d plus a. Replace d with d plus a. Only two functions will come. X square into sin square x. X square into sin square x is there. And again, x square into sin square x can be written as what? Sin square x is one, once again 1 plus cos 2x by 2. 1 plus cos 2x by 2. This principle you have to apply. Sin square x, cos square x, terms are there, then always write it as a imaginary part of e power I 2x. Like that. Sin 2x it is, actually. It is sin 2x, not sin square x, sin 2x. Sin 2x only. Mistakenly, sin square x is showing, it is sin 2x. Whenever sin ax is multiplied with x power k, imaginary part, real part will come into picture. Where k is greater than 1, k is a positive integer. K is greater than 1, k being the positive integer. These are some of the assignment problems. X cos ax, x minus f dash d by f of d into v by f of d. X square into cos x. Then cos x can be written as what? Imagine real part of e power ix. Cosecant x, general formula we have to apply. 1 by d square plus 1. 1 by d square plus 1 can be written as 1 by d plus I into d minus i. Take the partial fractions, general formula. 1 by d minus alpha of f of x. That formula you have to apply. Some of the examples. And here, the e power ax into v of x formula. Take e power ax outside here. 1 by d plus 1 of v of x. Integrate by parts. 1 by d square will be left out in the example number 13. And whenever sin cos are product, sin a cos b is there. Sin a cos b is what? Sin a plus b plus sin a minus b by 2. That formula you have to apply. And cos x into cos hyperbolic x is there. Cos hyperbolic x can be written as what? Cos hyperbolic x is e power x plus e power minus x by 2. Like that. X into sin hyperbolic x is there. X into e power x plus e power minus x by 2. Like that. Sin square x is there. Sin square x can be written as what? 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Whenever tan function is there, apply the general formula. 1 by d minus alpha of f of x is equal e power alpha x. This formula. For alpha x. Integration of tan ax into e power minus alpha x. Alpha will be identified with the formula 1 by d plus I d minus I. If minus sign is there, alpha is positive. D plus I is there, alpha is negative. Like that. Thank you, students. Thank you very much.